Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the .NET MAUI Linear Progress Bar Control. Using the Linear Progress Bar Control, you can show the progress of a task in rectangular shape. You can customize the control to show progress in determinate or indeterminate states, divide the progress bar into segments, and animate it smoothly. Before proceeding, make sure you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed on your machine. You should also have Visual Studio 2022 installed with the required .NET MAUI workloads. With that confirmed, let's start building an app. Open Visual Studio 2022 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose MAUI app and name my project example. After that, I continue with the .NET 7 framework and click Create to complete the project creation. Alright, my default MAUI application has been created, so let's check its output. Before that, I choose the Android emulator from this list and select a Pixel 5 emulator in which to see the output. The application is compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. Look here, my application says Hello World, welcome to MAUI app. Next, I will show you the steps to display the SyncFusion MAUI Linear Progress Bar Control. First, I need to install the SyncFusion MAUI Progress Bar NuGet package. So, I stop the debugging and open the NuGet package manager. In the Browse tab, I search for the SyncFusion MAUI Progress Bar package and install it in my project. I click OK to continue the installation. It takes a few seconds to complete. Okay, now let's initialize the MAUI Linear Progress Bar Control. The first thing to do is to register the handler for SyncFusion Core to map the cross-platform control API to the native Vue API. So, I open the MAUI program CS file and add the SyncFusion MAUI core hosting namespace. Then, I register the SyncFusion core handler by making a call to the method configure SyncFusion core. Next, I need to register the SyncFusion.NET MAUI trial license key. I open this app XAML CS file and register the trial license key using the register license method. To generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, I will initialize the control. I open this mainpage.xaml file and remove the default content from the content page section. Inside this page, I import the SyncFusion MAUI Progress Bar package namespace. Then, I include the Linear Progress Bar control. And set the progress property value as 25 to display the task progress. Okay, everything needed for rendering the control is configured. I save the changes and run the application. You can see the linear progress bar display the task progress. By default, the progress value should be specified between 0 and 100. Suppose I want to display a custom range, simply set the minimum property value to 10. And the maximum value to 80. Checking now, the progress value is rendered based on the specified range. Notice here, an estimation to completion is shown. If the progress is not estimable, then enable the isIndeterminate property. the progress is now shown in an indeterminate state. Now, let me demonstrate the steps to show the progress of a secondary task. To do that, I define the secondary progress property and set its value to 65. Here, I know the task and secondary task progress, so let me disable the isIndeterminate property. See here, the linear progress bar shows the secondary task's progress based on secondary progress value. Next, I am planning to split the linear progress bar into 4 segments, so set the segment count property to 4. Look now, the progress bar is split into 4 segments. By default, spacing between the segments is 3. Suppose I want to increase or decrease the spacing between the segments. Simply define the segment gap width with custom value. Here, I have set the gap width to 10. Check now, the spacing between the segments is 10. Now, let's see how to display the track, progress, and secondary progress value in custom colors. To do that, I define the track fill, progress fill, and secondary progress fill properties with custom colors. See here, the track, progress, and secondary progress indicators are shown in different colors. Apart from this color customization, you can visualize multiple ranges in solid or gradient colors using progress gradient stop property. Also, you can easily customize the progress bar's thickness, padding, and corner radius. To demonstrate, I am going to increase the thickness by setting custom height to the track, progress, and secondary progress. So, define the track height, progress height, and secondary progress height properties to 10. See now, the custom height is applied to the track, progress, and secondary progress. Finally, I will show you how to visualize the progress value changes in an interactive way. I will define the animation easing property. Here, you can animate the progress value with different animation types like bounce in, cubic out, spring in, and many more. Now, I am going to set the bounce in type to the animation easing property using the static resource. Here, I change the progress value to 55. Then, I define the animation duration property with the value 3000 milliseconds to animate the progress value. Because the animation duration is 1000 milliseconds by default. Checking now, the progress value is animated for 3000 milliseconds, and defined animation type is applied. In this video, we have seen how to create a .NET MAUI app using Visual Studio 2022, how to add the SyncFusion.NET MAUI linear progress bar control to the app, and how to customize it. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.